Hi, my name is John Doheny. I'm the president and CEO of Doheny's. In 1967, my parents started this company, and for over five decades, our family has been helping people like you make their pools perfect.
Today, our pool pros are going to walk you through the basics of pool chemistry. There are a lot of different chemicals out there, and it can be confusing for new pool owners. But don't worry. We're going to give you the lowdown on the purpose of each chemical and throw in a few tips as well.
Before we get started adding chemicals, we need to cover a couple of important safety practices. First, make sure you always read and follow safety information. Second, and this is very important, if the directions call for you to dilute your chemicals in water, always add your chemicals to the water. Do not add water to your chemicals. Why does it matter? Adding water to your chemicals can cause unexpected reactions and result in serious injury. The first category of chemicals we're going to talk about are balancers. Balancers have a very important job in your pool. As their name implies, they keep your pool chemistry in balance. Water that is out of balance can lead to a number of issues, including skin irritation, pool stains, and damage to your equipment. To find out if your water is in balance, test it by using a test kit or test strips. First, you want to make sure your alkalinity is in balance. Alkalinity is the measurement of your water's ability to maintain pH, so it is important to correct alkalinity imbalances before you attempt to correct pH. Proper alkalinity is between 80 and 120 parts per million. If you find your alkalinity is too high, use Doheny's pH minus. If it is too low, add some Doheny's alkalinity plus. Now let's talk about the basics of pH. pH is the measure of the acidity in your pool. If it's too high or too low, it can cause swimmer irritation and damage to your pool and equipment. Ideally, you want a pH between 7.2 and 7.6. If you discover your pH is off, this is where balancers come in. You can reduce your pH by adding Doheny's pH minus. If it's too low, use Doheny's pH plus to bring it up. Now we'll take a look at pool stabilizer. It's essentially cyanuric acid, or CYA. It's in your pool to stabilize the chlorine levels. Chlorine is vulnerable to heat and sunlight. When exposed to UV rays, chlorine evaporates rapidly. Without sufficient CYA, chlorine is reduced by as much as 95% within 2 hours. Stabilizers act to slow down the chlorine's degradation. You want to maintain your CYA levels at 40 to 60 parts per million to ensure your chlorine is effectively doing its job. If your water test shows low levels of CYA, add the appropriate amount of Doheny's pool stabilizer and conditioner. Be careful not to overstabilize because the stabilizer stays in your water and the only way to remove it is to drain water from your pool. Just follow the instructions on the packaging and you'll be fine. Another common balancer is calcium hardness control. Calcium hardness is the measure used to determine the amount of dissolved calcium and magnesium in your swimming pool. Basically, it tells you the hardness or softness of your water. For pools filled or topped off with well water, it's even more important to keep an eye on calcium hardness, as well water tends to have higher levels of these chemicals. Hard water has high levels of calcium and magnesium, while soft water has low levels. Just like pH and total alkalinity, it's important to keep the calcium hardness balanced to prevent damage to your pool or equipment. If your calcium hardness drops below 150 parts per million, it becomes corrosive. If you don't manually add calcium or magnesium back into the pool, the water will begin to take the mineral it needs from your pool or pool equipment. Pool water with a calcium hardness over 400 parts per million can become cloudy and cause scaling, which is a buildup of calcium on your pool and equipment. Doheny's calcium hardness reducer and calcium hardness increaser will help you keep your levels exactly where they need to be. The next category of pool chemicals are sanitizers. Sanitizers are used to kill bacteria and inhibit the growth of viruses, algae, and other organic contaminants. Chlorine, the most common pool water sanitizer, is used to kill bacteria that could otherwise make swimmers sick. The most popular type of chlorine for everyday pool use is trichlor-S-triazinetrione, otherwise known as trichlor. Trichlor is stabilized, meaning it contains cyanuric acid, which acts like a sunscreen to slow down chlorine burn-off. It's available in sticks or tabs and is added to your pool through an automated or floating chlorinator. You can also use dichlorchlorine. It's not as common, but some people find it easier to use because it comes in granular form and it can be added directly to the pool water by hand. Whichever type you use, chlorine levels should be maintained at 1 to 3 parts per million. Always look for 99% pure chlorine. If it is lower, you may feel like you are saving money, but in the long run, you'll spend more. At Doheny's, we've turned chlorine into an art form. Our 99% pure chlorine tabs are also highly compressed so they dissolve more slowly and last longer. Plus, they come wrapped for odor reduction and ease of handling. Next, we're going to talk about shock. Primarily, shock is a form of chlorine, but it does more than sanitize your pool water. Shock also takes care of the byproduct left by the chlorine in your pool as it breaks down. Here's how shock works. When chlorine breaks down, it forms tiny particles called chloramines. They can irritate your skin and eyes and create a strong odor. Plus, they can greatly reduce the effectiveness of your chlorine. These little guys will float around your pool until something comes along to get rid of them. That's where shock comes in. It attacks those inactive particles and breaks them apart. It's important to shock your pool once a week. Adding chlorine shock quickly raises the level of chlorine in your pool and can make the water irritating to swimmers, so it's safest to wait 12 hours for the shock to work before swimming. Your best bet is to shock in the evening so the chlorine doesn't burn off in the sun. We like to shock our pool on a Thursday to make sure it's clean and ready for weekend swimmers. Another option is non-chlorine shock, also called oxidizing shock. If using oxidizing shock, there's no need to wait 12 hours before swimming. Your pool will be swimmer ready in 15 minutes. However, oxidizing shock doesn't sanitize like chlorine shock. It just breaks down the chloramines. Now we are going to get into our last category, specialty chemicals. Specialty chemicals are designed to solve specific issues you may have with your pool water. Algicides are used to kill algae. Algae preventers are used to inhibit algae growth before it starts. Algae growth in your pool can be difficult to get rid of, and it can cause your water to become cloudy and discolored. Left unchecked, it may also cause skin irritation and damage to your pool equipment. Our algicides and algae preventers are effective against all common algaes, and they won't foam or cloud your swimming pool. Water clarifiers help keep your water clear. Often, pool cloudiness is caused by particles in the water that are too tiny for your filter to grab. Water clarifiers bind these tiny particles together so they are large enough to be trapped. If we notice our pool looking cloudy, we add Doheny Water Clarifier Plus. Its non-foaming, non-staining formula works quickly to clear out those particles and bring your pool water back to life. Metal removers are used to reduce the level of metal in your pool water. All pool water contains trace amounts of metal such as copper and iron in solution. At normal levels, they are harmless, and even at higher levels, they are non-toxic. The issues they cause are aesthetic ones. High metal levels can cause staining, scaling, and discoloration of your pool. If you have elevated levels of metal in your pool, use Doheny's metal removers to bring those levels down and prevent unsightly stains.
And that's a wrap. You now know the basics of pool chemistry. If you have any further questions, please visit our website to chat with one of our expert pool pros or to view one of our many tutorials. All the products shown in this video are available to you on Doheny.com. As always, like our video and subscribe to our YouTube channel for all of our future instructional videos.